Hello there. If you are watching this because you want to do better on the Chapter 7 test that we've taken, and you'd like to know how to get these problems right. Okay, so I'm going to go through the problems with you. Hopefully you didn't miss number one. It is simply getting the area of a parallelogram. And remember, all you have to do is multiply how wide it is at the bottom times how tall it is. The length times the height. The width times the height. The base times the height. And again, you can see that if I were to cut off this triangle over here and slide it over here, because these lines are parallel, it would fit perfectly right here, which would mean I would now have a rectangle, a special kind of rectangle, a square, because it's 2 times 2. So 2 times 2 is 4, and foot times foot is square feet. Okay, 4 square feet on that one. You can see a triangle is half of a rectangle. So if this was the rectangle I wanted the area of, I would do 2 times 4, but that triangle is half of the rectangle. That's why the formula for the area of a triangle is 1 half of the base times the height. How wide is it? That's 2. How tall is it? That's 4. So instead of 2 times 8, 16, I get half of that, which is 8 square inches. And again, you can do that by doing 2 times 4. Sorry, I wrote 8 here. 1 half times 2 times 4. You can do 2 times 4 and get 8 and take half of that, which is 4. Or you can take half of 2, which is 1, and multiply it by 4 and get 4. Or half of 4, which is 2, and 2 times 2 is 4. Either way, you get 4 square inches. A kite has a pretty cool formula where you're going to get half of the diagonals. So this diagonal is 6 plus 8, which is 14. This one is 6 plus 6, which is 12. And I'm going to do half of 6 plus 8 is 7, and half of 6 plus 6 is 12. Is 6, and do 7 times 6 is 42 square millimeters on that one. Okay, and I could do these four triangles, right? Half of 6 is 3, 3 times 8 is 24, 3 times 8 is 24, 3 times 3 I'm sorry, 3 times 6 is 18, and I just screwed up and need to get the... All right, hello. If you are here, you are here to learn how to get all the problems that you missed on the test correct so that you can do a retake and just learn about the problems that you got wrong, okay? Nothing wrong with making mistakes as long as you pay attention to those mistakes and learn from them, right? That's the idea. You want to get better at things, right? So first off, we have the formula for the area of a parallelogram. It's just the base times the height. How wide is it times how tall is it? Remember, the easiest thing to get the area of is a rectangle, and you're just multiplying how wide is it times how tall, right? So this was 3 tall and 5 wide. The area would be 15. Right, and you can see that by drawing the lines, saying that's 3 rows tall, and it's 5 columns wide. How many squares? 15. 3 times 5, 15 square units. Okay, I often compare them. Right. Well, a parallelogram, because this line is parallel to that, I could chop off this triangle here and slide it over here, and because that's parallel, it would fit perfectly, and I would make a rectangle, a special kind of rectangle, because it's 2 by 2, it's a square. What's the area? 2 times 2 is 4, and we're talking about square feet, right? Feet times feet is feet to the second power, square feet. Number one, you're done. Now, you can see that this triangle is half of a rectangle. If I got the area of that rectangle, I would do 4 inches times 2 inches, 8 square inches. Well, the formula for the area of a triangle is half of what they call the base times the height. How wide is it at the bottom? 2. How tall is it? 4. 1/2 times 2 times 4 is half of 8, which is 4. This time we're talking square inches. And again, you could do 2 times 4 and take half of it, or you could take half of the 2, 1 times 4, get 4, or half of the 4, which is 2, and 2 times 2 is 4. All three times you get 4 square inches. Now, kite is special. You want to get the length of the diagonals. 6 plus 8 for one of them is 14, and 6 plus 6 for the other is 12, and it's going to be half of the first diagonal times the second. So 1/2 of 14 times 12 is the way I'm going to do it. Half of 14 is 7. 7 times 12 is 7 tens and 7 twos. 7 tens is 70. 7 twos is 14. So 7 times 12 is 84. And now we're talking square millimeters. Pretty cool thing to get these kites. That's something that's fairly new for me. Okay, we never really had to get kites most of the time. Now, trapezoids I love. Don't worry about that formula when they tell you that the area is base 1 plus base 2 divided by 2 times 8. What I do is I treat the base 1 and base 2 as just the top and the bottom. Even if they're turned sideways, I name one the top, one the bottom. So, and I'm getting the average of the top and the bottom, which is the top plus the bottom divided by 2. That's how I think of it. The average of the top and the bottom times how tall. Okay, so 10 plus 13 is 23. And 23 divided by 2 is 11.5. And don't freak out. And it's 11.5 because when you multiply anything by 10, remember in fifth grade your teacher told you to add a zero. But now in sixth grade, you say if it's multiplied by 10, I move the decimal over one spot to the right. If I multiply it by 100, it's 2 spots, 1,000, 3 spots. And the cool thing about remembering it that way is when I divide by 10, I move it decimal one spot to the left. Or 100, 2 spots to the left, right? So 11.5, move it over one spot, is 115. What are our units? Square miles, 115 square miles on that one. Okay, running out of room over there. All right, this time, again, we're using this formula because it's the area of a triangle. Area equals 1/2 the base times the height. I plug this in, and I'm going to have two of the numbers. This time I have the area is 1/2 times 18 times the height. What's half of 18? 9. And I have 9 times h is 72. Well, if I want the h by itself, I have to get rid of that times 9. How do you get rid of it times 9? Do the opposite. What's the opposite of times 9? Divided by 9. But if I do it to this side, I have to do the same thing to the other side. They cancel out over here. The height equals 72 divided by 9. Well, 9 times what is 72? 9 times 8. So now the area is the square units. The height is just the units, 8 meters. Boom. All right, number 6. The surface area of a rectangular prism means I have to get the area of the top, which is the same as the bottom. I have to get the area of the front, which is the same as the back. The area of the right side, which is the same as the left. Now that top is 3 times 3, which is 9, which means the bottom is 9. The front is 3 times 7, 21, and the back will be 21. And guess what? The right side is also 3 times 7, which is 11. Add them all up. I'm going to put this with that, make 30. This with that, make 30. 30 and 30 is 60, plus 42. That makes 102, and I could double check if I wanted to, but I'm pretty sure that is a correct answer. The surface area, that's the area of the entire face, every face of that shape. Cover it with stickers, it would take 102 square inches. Triangular prism, I have to get that triangle at the bottom. Okay, and I have to say, what is this? It's 1.3. 1.3 times 1.1, half of that, half of 1.3 is 0.65. And 0.65 times 1.1, pretend there's no decimal, 65 times 11. When I get done multiplying, I get 715. Now I go back and say, okay, I moved that over twice and moved that over once. I have to go back three spots. So that triangle at the bottom is 0.715. Okay, now I have to do these triangles coming up. Okay, now that is an equilateral triangle, so each of these three triangles is going to be 1.3 and 2.6. Now this time, when I do half of the base times the height, I'm going to do half of the 2.6 times the 1.3. Because half of 2.6 is 1.3, and 1.3 times 1.3 is like 13 times 13, which is 169, but I got to move it back two spots. Okay, now that's one of these triangles. There's three of those. So I have 1.69, 1.69, and 1.69, plus that 0.715. Add zeros if it helps, and it usually does. 27 and 1 is 28. 9 and 18 is 27. And 3 and 2 is 5. So 5.785. And it looks like I made a mistake on that one. Yeah, there we go. That is actually correct. Double checked. 5.785, what are my units? Square feet. Boom. We have the first half of the test done. Let's see if we can do the second half before this bell rings. Trying to get this done during my prep. All right, so the volume is actually easier. The volume of rectangular prisms is you get the area of the top, right, layer, and then times how many layers. You're basically multiplying the three numbers. So the volume of this is going to be 1 half times 3 eighths times 2 thirds. And if I'm multiplying fractions, I can go straight across the top, 1 times 3 times 2, and straight across the bottom, 2 times 8 times 3. 1 times 3 is 3, times 2 is 6. 2 times 8 is 16, and 16 times 3 is 48. And then I simplify. How do I simplify? Well, 6 goes into the top one time, goes into 48 eight times. So this is 1/8 square millimeters. I could also have cross-canceled is when you see a number that fits into the top and bottom. 2 goes into the bottom here, it goes into the top there. 3 goes into the top here, it goes into the bottom here. So 1 times 1 times 1 is 1. 1 times 8 times 1 is 8. I still get 1/8 square. Sorry, I said square, didn't I? Millimeter times millimeter times millimeter. Volume is cubic units. Phew, almost lost a point. All right, here is a cube, 3/4 times 3/4 times 3/4. 3 times 3 times 3 is 9 times 3, or 27. 4 times 4 times 4 is 16 times 4, 64 feet cubed. Boom, I'm done. I can't simplify. That's as simple as it gets. What's the height of the trapezoid? Well, again, I have to get the top plus the bottom divided by 2, the average of the top and bottom, times the height, equals the area. Now I know the area is 26, I know the top is 4, bottom is 9, divide that by 2, multiply it by the height. 13 divided by 2 is 6.5 or 6.5. And if I want to get rid of that, I have to divide by 6.5, right? And there's different ways to do. You can also do what's called a fraction buster. That means you multiply it by the reciprocal. One way to get rid of that, And you can see 2 times 13 is 26. 13 times 2 is 26. That's 1. 1 times the height is the height. And put a 1 under that when I multiply. And let's simplify. 13 goes into the bottom once, goes into the twice, into the 26 twice. Now, all I have is 2 times 2 on top and 1 times 1 on the bottom, or 4 feet. Boom, I'm done. Just 4 feet, not square feet. Remember, the area is square units. What do I do here? I have to get the area of this shape. Well, that is weird. Well, but check this out. Now I have 2 trapezoids. This first one, top plus the bottom, 24 plus 28 divided by 2 times 7. Now you could also, what's the average of 24 and 28? Well, what's right in the middle of 24 and 28? 26. 24 plus 28 is 52. 52 divided by 2, 26. So I'm have 26 times 7 on this one, which is 7 quarters and 7 pennies. 175 is 7 quarters. 7 cents is 7 pennies. 175 and 7 is 182. Area of this is 182 square feet. This one, 15 plus 19 divided by 2. Or what's right in between 15 and 19? 17, right? 34 divided by 2 is 17. 17 times 7. 7 tens is 70. 7 nines is, sorry, 7 sevens is 49. 49 is 70. 119. So 182 here, 119 here. What's the total? Okay. Now, that is the area in square feet. The carpet costs $175 per square foot. How much does it cost to carpet the hallway? I have to multiply this 301 square feet times 175. 5 times 1, 5 times 0, 5 times 3. Placeholder, 7 times 1, 7 times 0, 7 times 3. 2 placeholders, 1 times 1, 1 times 0, 1 times 3. Add. And then I had to move that over twice, so I had to go back twice in my answer. The answer is $526.75. All right, last one. One roll of wallpaper covers 300 square feet. What's the least number of rolls of wallpaper needed to cover the walls of a room in the shape of a rectangular prism with a length of 15 feet and a width of 15 feet and a height of 9 feet? This is a weird question in a lot of ways. Am I actually covering a rectangular prism? All right. Because it just says the walls. It doesn't say the floor and the ceiling, right? So I'm just getting the front, the back, the right, and the left on this one. I'm not going to include the ceiling and the floor, right? So anyway, 15 by 15 and 9 feet tall. Okay. So 15 by 15 and a height of 9 feet. So really, I'm just getting 4 rectangles, these walls, and each of those is 9 times 15, which is 135. But I need 4 of those. 12, 14, 4. 540. So that's 540 square feet. Okay, and each roll is 300 square feet. So I need at least 2 of them, right? I'm going to say 2 rolls because that makes 600 is my answer. Okay, and again, weird question because it is a rectangular prism, but they said just to cover the walls. It does not say to cover the ceiling or the floor. So I'm going with 2 rolls there. Okay. Hopefully this helps you. You copy You learn and you earn, and then you can do a retake. Okay? Fix all the ones you missed.